What's up, guys? Thank you so much for coming back to my channel. My name is Lexi, aka the Divabetic on social media. Today we are going to be talking about a Peloton hack. Peloton is amazing. I have their monthly virtual membership thing, but I didn't want to spend $1,500, $1,600 for a Peloton bike, so I did a hack. So basically, I have the Peloton virtual membership. This allows me to access all the Peloton classes live, all the recorded ones. It doesn't matter if it's like the cycling or the weightlifting, all those. I think I pay like $12 or $14 a month. You know, you can call them your personal coaches. I feel like they're coaching me during the workouts, but you know, they're obviously recording. So I have my Peloton virtual membership. I have a bike that I ordered on Amazon that was about $600, and we'll get into that in just a little bit. I also have a cadence sensor that basically allows my Amazon bike to track my cadence the way that a Peloton bike would track your cadence if you're on the Peloton bike. I also have an Apple Watch, so it monitors my heart rate the same way that the Peloton bike would monitor your heart rate, or has the capability to monitor your heart rate. And I also, this is the last thing, I know it sounds like a lot, I also have just a fan that I got for my bike so that when I get hot, your girl is really working, okay? I can turn the fan on, I don't have to be sitting there like drenched in sweat, but honestly, I feel like I'm working harder when I'm sweating, so sometimes I just like let the sweat come. So, okay, I have the Sunny something bike. I will put the name here because I can't remember which model it is. Now, I got this particular bike because there's plenty of bikes. You can get bikes as cheap as like $200, cycling bikes, spin bikes. I got this particular one because it has the magnetic wheel. So your ride is a lot smoother. It doesn't have the chain and you can't hear any, like you literally can't hear my bike when I ride it. As a matter of fact, I might show you. I'm gonna put a few little flashbacks from when I first got the bike. I'm dying. Basically, the way that my bike is set up, it is facing, well, I turn my TV to face it whenever I do workout, and I cast my classes, my spin class, to my TV because I like to be able to see my cadence, the people who are riding with me. I like to be able to see all that on my phone. You can give people high fives on the app, so it's a lot more interactive to do it through the app versus doing it on TV, but you can do it on TV. I bought a TV specifically for my bike. So I got an open box TV from Walmart. I think it was $60. Original price was like 100 something. There was nothing wrong with it. It was still in the plastic. You know, it was like the box was just open and they just decided they didn't want it. I don't know why. So the great thing about the Roku, and the specific brand that I have is the On, O-N-N, it's able to get the app. So like you can have the Peloton app. I have the Peloton app on the TV, but like I said, using the app on my phone and just casting it allows me to be more interactive during my rides. You can ride with people. So my mom and I will sometimes ride together, especially during quarantine. We all know that those quarantine pounds came like nothing, and it's a little bit tricky to get them off if you're not going to the gym or you're not able to go outside. Now I'm a lot more comfortable being inside and working out at the house just because your girl is not trying to get COVID. The total that I spent was about maybe $800, a little less than $800 for everything. Also, you know, keep in mind, yeah, I got the TV specifically for my knockoff Peloton bike, but it's here in my office. My bike is in my office. So, you know, now I have a TV in my office. I just get distracted. Sometimes I should not have my TV on when I'm working, but I do. You're paying a lot of money, but it's for things that you'll be able to use outside of your bike. Like the fan that I got, it's actually created so that you can wear it around your neck when you go on walks and stuff. Like I said, your Apple Watch, I'm not even gonna count the Apple Watch in the pricing, but if you want to, I mean, you can go get a cheap Apple Watch, or not even an Apple Watch, just a fitness band. I think they make them as cheap as like 30 or 40 bucks now. There's so many different ways to achieve the Peloton experience. That's what I was looking for, the Peloton experience, without having to pay the Peloton price. Another thing to consider when purchasing a Peloton, actual Peloton bike, is that the membership fee or the monthly membership to have access to the classes is actually more than it is if you just have the virtual membership. So that's really interesting to me. I want to say it's like $30-something a month if you have the Peloton bike, whereas for us non-Peloton bikers, it's, you know, like $12 or $14 or something like that. So I will leave the links below to everything that I have, and you guys just let me know your thoughts. And also, there's like 4 different bikes that I think are great options or great alternatives to the Peloton bike. Like I said, I got the one with the magnetic wheel, but there's a couple of them made by the brand Sunny. Sunny is the brand of my bike that are also really good. They have the traditional like chain, I guess you can call it. So they don't have the magnetic feel. So it's not gonna feel the exact same as the Peloton bike, I guess you could say, but you still accomplish the exact same thing. As long as you're on a bike and your pedals are moving and you're able to adjust your resistance, you got it. You got the Peloton experience. So let me know your guys' thoughts. Thank you so much for watching, and I really hope this was helpful. Make sure to subscribe to this channel. Hit that notification bell so that you can get an update every single time that I upload something. If you haven't noticed, the area that I like to talk about is like dupes and just affordable alternatives. So if that's something that you think you'll be interested in, make sure to subscribe. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope to see you next time. Bye!